I tell people, please call me representative, not congresswoman, because that's my job. I'm a representative.
Representative Sharice Davids' story may not sound like your average biography of a lawmaker, but it's a story millions of Americans know intimately. She's the oldest of three, raised by a single mother in the military. She was the first in her family to go to college, starting at community college and ending with law school at Cornell University. From there, she took on the very male-dominated world of MMA fighting. And in 2018, in a midterm of historical firsts, she became one of the first two Native American women elected to Congress, the first lesbian to represent her district that she was able to flip from red to blue for the first time in nearly a decade. We met up at the Transportation Walk in D.C., a spot close to her heart. She was a White House fellow at the Department of Transportation, and she's currently on the House's Transportation and Infrastructure Committee.
It's interesting growing up with what I feel like is the exact experience that we talk about, which is that my mom worked really hard to make sure that we had opportunities that she didn't have. In some ways felt kind of like a story you would see in a movie or something. It feels like an interesting evolution, but you know, it also feels very like right. Like I feel like I'm in the right place. I feel like I'm doing the work that I'm supposed to be doing, and that feels really good. What possessed me to get in the cage?
Yeah. Like what? Yeah, what threw you in there? What made you want to do that?
You know, when I was growing up, I was like obsessed with Bruce Lee. And I mean, I would like run around and put like little white button-up shirts on and like tie a black belt around and just run around punching and stuff. But my mom couldn't really afford to put us into martial arts. And so when I was, I think 19, I realized, wait, I'm an adult. I have a job. I can pay for my own martial arts. So I started doing capoeira, which is a Brazilian martial art. And while I just got obsessed. The coach that I was, whose gym I was training at, I was like, you should do a martial arts fight, you know, MMA fight.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't think so. you learn, like, in the most literal sense, like, to get knocked down and have to get back up over and over and over.
How do you go from that to then running for Congress?
Big picture, we need more women and people of color and LGBT folks and first-generation college students and people who had to work through school running. I just felt like there were so many people who maybe weren't in the political sphere for the right reasons. It didn't feel like we had a lot of trust in our elected officials. Frankly, looked at the field of candidates and thought, I'm just as qualified, if not more qualified, than the people that are in this race. And if I'm going to be asking the question, what are we going to do about it, then I should be part of the answer.
Do you ever feel pressure as one of the first? Do you feel pressure to perform or pressure to not mess up?
It hasn't really sunk in what that even means to be one of the first. It doesn't feel like any more pressure than being a member of Congress. I mean, that in and of itself, there are plenty of times where I was talking to my friend the other day while I was walking to work. And I was, hey, what are you doing? And he said, I'm driving into the office. And I was like, yeah, I'm walking to work. By work, I mean the Capitol is right in front of me. And
I'll be writing laws
yeah,
today.
Yeah.
How much do you think your identity impacts how you approach your job?
It helps me see that there are lots of different lenses and experiences that shape the way people experience this world. Your experience is just as real and valid and complex and nuanced and like all of the things that we experience as humans, it might be slightly different than mine or vastly different than mine, depending on what we're talking about, but it's still just as real and valid and should be heard and be part of how we come up with our policy.
What kind of country do you think America is right now?
I kind of think of us as being that kind of lanky teenager that's trying to figure out who we are. We've gotten to this point where we're, in some ways, it feels like we're a teenager that's kind of lashing out and we're like, I don't want it to be this way. Wait a minute, I do want it to be this way. Hold on, let me think for a second. I think we're learning what this experiment of a representative democracy means.